In dimensionals part 1, we have written the dimensional formulae for some physical quantities. Now let's continue to write the dimensional formulae for some more physical quantities. Volume, the dimensions will have m0, L3, because it is the product of three lengths and there is no T term. Therefore, the volume dimensional formula is m0 L3 T0. Now, let's talk about the pressure. Pressure is nothing but force per unit area. Now here the force is ml t minus 2 and area L2. Therefore, the formula for pressure will be m1 l minus 1 t minus 2. Pressure and stress will have the same dimensional formula because both are force per unit area only. Now, density. Density can be written as mass per unit volume. Therefore, the dimensional formula for density, which is represented by rho, is m1 l minus 3, as the volume term is in the denominator, and t0. Now let us write some physical quantities which involve the current. Now let's write the dimensional formula for charge. From the definition of the current, I is equal to Q by T. Therefore, charge is equal to I times T. For I, we write A. For T, of course, it's time, then m0, l0. Now, let us write for potential difference. We know that potential difference is nothing but work done per unit charge. For work done, ML2 T minus 2 is the dimensional formula we have written already, and for Q it is AT. So finally, by simplifying this one, we will get M1 L2 T to the power of minus 3 and A to the power of minus 1. Now, let's write for resistance. Resistance is nothing but potential divided by the current. So, the dimensional formula of V by the dimensional formula of I, which gives us m1 l2 t minus 3 and a minus 1, and the dimensional formula for current is A. So finally it will be m1 l2 t minus 3 and a minus 2. The dimensional formula of specific heat. We know that Q is equal to specific heat. We know that Q is equal to MC delta T. Therefore, C is equal to Q by M delta T. For Q, ML2 T minus 2, because Q is nothing but energy, heat energy, and M, and this delta T is a temperature term, therefore we have to write K. So finally, the dimensional formula for specific heat is M0 L2 T to the power of minus 2 and K to the power of minus 1. So like this, if you know the formulae for any physical quantity, you can express them in the dimensional formula. In all these dimensions, we have written mass, length, time, current, and then temperature. So these are the terms which we have used to express the dimensional formula of any physical quantity.